Alright guys, so we're going to truck bed the outer section of my Mitsubishi Strada, this section here. We'd already done the front, so it's going to be like this texture that we already did the front. We're just doing this back section now. We sanded it with 80 grit sandpaper. You don't have to be too special with it. Wiped it down with the denatured alcohol, got all the dust cleaned out. I'm not doing in the bed, but I am going to do in the bed later, so I'm not even bothered with taping it off. I'm going to do right up on the lips though, get that done. These are for my roll bar. I put the bolts back in so that it wouldn't gum up my threads or anything crazy. So we're getting prepped right now. We're going to be mixing this with one of these bottles of gray, and I forget how many ounces of this stuff goes in there. Yeah, I think something like that. We'll look it all up. It says it right on here somewhere. But I'll put this in the description below. It's a Raptor liner. Just click on the link. It's really, really easy. This is the first vehicle I've done. You're about to see how easy it is. I mean, it really, really, I was really happy with how it turned out. We're gonna put hardener and the color in. Let's see, color bottle, Raptor tunable base. Whatever, I'm gonna read it and find out. We're gonna mix it all up, and I'm using the more expensive gun. This was like 80, 90 bucks, something like that. But I can adjust the spray. So I'm doing a fine spray on all the exterior of the truck, and then I'll do a coarse inside the bed. So, I'll put this gun in the description below too. Makes it way easier. The gun that it comes with is just coarse. So all you get is coarse texture. This you can adjust it. So, let me mix up some bottles of stuff. So it's 8 ounces of hardener. It goes to that line is what we're gonna do with this hardener. A full bottle of this, both into there. And then that screws right onto this gun. And I put a dryer, I'll find one of these inline dryer right on the gun too, just to help keep the moisture out. So we're going to dump the color in there. I'm doing gray. This whole bottle in there. And then 8 ounces of the hardener. Going in there, just fills right to the line. That, and we're gonna put the cap on it and shake the piss out of it. You can almost hear it mix. Nice and even colored. This is a metallic charcoal gray is what I'm using. Stick this down in, screw it on. All right, pause. It's all friggin' true Florida form. It starts raining when we're ready to friggin' paint. Isn't that awesome, guys? Sprinkling now. And everything's nice and wet. As soon as it stops sprinkling, the sun will come out. The sun's already trying to come out. As soon as the sun comes out and it's done raining, I'll wipe everything down with alcohol again. Nothing's easy in life, is it? The rain stopped. I blew off a little bit of the water with the air hose. I'm gonna wipe it all down with the prep all. I'll put some of this in the description below for you as well. I'm gonna give her a quick wipe down, get it all dried off so we can start painting. Cross our fingers that this stuff hasn't freaking started hardening up. We'll find out. All wiped off and ready to go, and it starts raining again. Still raining, but I saw somebody coming around the corner for me. Yay, Johnny! All right, we're gonna wipe her down one more time. Nice. Thanks, Johnny!
No problem.
All right, we're gonna do this. A light texture. Give me that sticky coat.
I put my mask.
Hey.
Yeah, there we go.
Safety first, people. Yeah. Safety first.
Safety third. Doing really thin coats, little at a time.
freaking raining, isn't it?
Yes. Don't worry, you're dry. I'm out here in the rain.
Yeah.
You're a giver, Jason.
That's all that's important.
Oh, it's starting to cover up now, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm going on thicker now. As you're doing thin at first, kind of make a sticky, tacky coat, you know? And then you go thin in the very last bit to even it all out so you don't have any lines in it.
Put it on even.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to do that black inside. That's all. I'm gonna have to take it off and do it black in there.
Under your window, are you spraying that black or?
Not under the window. What are you talking about under the window?
See the your glass and then underneath the aluminum showing?
You mean the white?
Is that white or silver?
The white rail that's around the glass?
Yeah, that's right underneath.
Yeah, I'm going to be spraying all that seal and everything black.
Okay. Well, I know. I wasn't worried about coverage, just getting some kind of roughage under there or something. Okay.
That much to your thumb.
Left wow, in there. That's a lot.
I need to pause it. I need a container. And we're starting to peel the tape and stuff off of it. See where the water's dripped down on it and everything, but it should be fine as long as it evaporates off. But when you're pulling the tape off, you want to get it to pull away from the truck bed coating, so like this, pull it like this away. like that. Alright, I need both hands. Boom. Just like that. Getting better. Getting it all off. I haven't gotten the middle out yet because I don't dare put down the tailgate yet. So, not bad for, I mean, somebody that doesn't really do truck bed coating at all. Went on pretty good. Yeah, anyways, that's about it, guys. I'll put all the stuff that we used today in the description below. Just click on the links. It'll take you right to them. If this helped you out in any way, shape, or form, give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. Peace.